We've all experienced a moment when a friend really could have come in handy.
My brother got held back in first grade, and we were in the same grade up until that point. And he was he just had trouble reading, unlike most kids, because he just was more challenged than the next person. And people would always make fun of him and push him around and stuff because of that. I remember how many times I had to go to him because he'd be crying on the playground or whatever, and then people would make fun of me also because I'd, you know, be the one to stand up for him. And it's just, people can be so mean.
Well, it's my junior year in high school, and I just got into my next class and asked my teacher if I could go to the bathroom. So, I was in the bathroom washing my hands, and as soon as I was about to walk out, two kids walked in and said, "Where do you think you're going?" So I just told them to get out of my way. And they said, "No, you're not going anywhere." So I just pushed them out of my way and walked into the hallway, and that was kind of the end of it. It was kind of a scary experience because I didn't know what was going to happen. I thought they were going to try to keep me in the bathroom and maybe possibly beat me up or take my stuff or whatever.
Up around sixth grade, my best friend actually decided to turn on us, I guess. I told her that I didn't want any more bad influences in my life. I'd been talking to my mom. I told her we couldn't really talk anymore, and so she brought some of my other friends, and they started circling me at lunch and pushing me and shoving me and saying just such rude things. And I wanted to do something. I wanted some help, but I didn't want to get in trouble, because if I touched them, I'd get in trouble, so I kept letting them shove me.
Well, kids used to tease me a lot, and really throughout all my years in school, especially early on. I remember one time I was in elementary school on a school trip, and someone took a picture of me in a compromising position, and I guess that photo got out, and people would call me all sorts of names, and they wouldn't even go near me. They wouldn't talk to me for months, and it really just broke my heart because the people I thought were my friends really, really weren't my friends.
When I was in elementary school, I was really big, so everyone thought I was intimidating. They thought I was a bully, so no one talked to me. I was ostracized a lot, and that stayed that way until probably high school. I didn't have any friends because of it, and I was teased because, well, it's big, and I was quiet, and I was by myself. It was painful. It hurt.
Well, during my parents' divorce, every night it was just a scream match, and my father said the most terrible things to me. He called me a pathetic loser with no friends, and he said even more worse stuff than that. And then just a few months ago, my brother said the exact same thing. He was calling me fat, pathetic, piece of crap loser with no friends, and it did get to me, but I learned how to cope with it, and it doesn't get to me anymore.
Sometimes you just really need somebody in your life to, you know, make a difference.
I really could use someone to talk to. I really need someone.
Knowing that people could be that mean and that cruel, and that people just don't care about other people's feelings, it just hurts me so much.
Our experiences are just a small sample of what children, teens, and young adults are experiencing on a daily basis. While this isn't a problem we can single-handedly change overnight, we have made it our goal to be what we and millions of others could have used at some point in their lives. A friend. As friends, we have supported, protected, and cherished each other thick and thin. We are not only each other's friends, but each other's guardian. I'll be your keeper for life as your guardian. I'll be your warrior of care, your first warden. I'll be your angel on call, I'll be your command. The greatest honor of all as your guardian. For victims of bullying and people who are simply going through a rough experience, our friendship can go 1,000 miles. We have made a pact to live life with a positive outlook, an open heart, and a smile on our face, hoping and being a friend to those who could really use a ray of sunshine in their lives. If everyone could share this positivity and be a guardian for just one person, feelings of sadness and loneliness could end across the world. If everyone could just be nice, the world would be a better place. DoSomething.org has grown our friendships over the past 2 years. Because of them and because of our experiences we have shared, we have learned to pay it forward to each other and anyone else. After all, an act of kindness can go a long, long way.
Do something!
That's really cool. Someone.